All students, today we are going to see about the properties of vector. It is very very essential. So properties of vector. Why we are considering the properties of vector? It is very essential for cloning to be done in the plasmid. So it is not mere the properties, it is required property of a vector for the cloning processes in genetic engineering. So what are they? Number one, it is size of the vector. It should be small in size. Small in size, which means less than 1 kilo base pairs information, which means 1000 base pairs, not mere bases, it is 1000 base pairs. We knew that adenine always paired with thymine, cytosine always paired with guanine. This is called base pair. This nitrogenous base pairs, we need at least less than 1000 base pairs. This is a small size, very small size. In addition to that, a vector should contain low molecular weight also. For example, if you are taking a glucose, it consists of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. There is a separate molecular weight for carbon and for hydrogen and for oxygen. So we are saying that molecular weight, it is about a substance, a compound which is present in the bases. So the DNA are the bases, nitrogenous bases, in the word itself explains, nitrogen also there, nitrogen, okay. So these are all included in the molecular weight of the vector. When the vector has less than 1000 base pair, it is nothing but a low molecular weight, okay. Then what is next property? Next property, it is the presence of a specific nucleotide sequence. We are calling this specific nucleotide sequence which is present on the plasmid as O or I, which means origin of replication sequence. It means what? Origin of replication sequence. This is called ORI sequence. What is the need of this sequence? It will initiate the replication. When the replication will take place, for an example, this is the plasmid. It should be a hybrid plasmid in which we have introduced our desired DNA segment. This hybrid plasmid is once after the splicing, we are introducing into the host cell. The host cell must allow the replication. For that, there is a need of origin of replication sequence. In the plasmid structure itself, a small region, this is O or I region in the plasmid. It is a specific sequence present in the plasmid itself. The next important property, it is suitable marker. This is always present in the plasmid. the most suitable marker available in the plasmid, it is antibiotic resistance. What is the use of this suitable marker or selectable marker present in the plasmid? It is, once the plasmid is introduced with the DNA insert, we will introduce the hybrid plasmid into the host cell like a bacterium. Then the bacterium will be cultured. During the culturing process, it is a plant tissue culture method only. During the culturing process, how many numbers of bacterium are having this introduced plasmid structure? How many numbers of bacterium does not with this bacteria plasmid structure? We have to isolate, separate. If this suitable markers are present, we are going to call that plasmid as a transformants. Those don't have this selectable marker, then we will say it is non-transformants. So transformants and non-transformants, to differentiate this, we are using this suitable marker, and it is very important property present in the plasmid structure, exhibited in the plasmid structure. We are going to see the next property. The next property is, it is cloning site. Cloning site or unique site which is present in the plasmid itself. This cloning site, the presence of the cloning site, it is to which only the desired DNA fragments can be introduced. So this is very important site. This desired DNA fragment can be introduced. This sentence explains that the plasmid has a specific sequence to which only we are introducing our DNA fragments, our desired DNA fragments. The bacterium may contain more than one cloning site, CS. In this case, the presence of more than one cloning site in a plasmid of a bacterium, we will say a separate name, a new name. This is called polylinker, because we are going to link again. See, follow the diagram. This is the plasmid. During the genetic engineering, at some region we are introducing our desired DNA segment. For this specific introduction, we need cloning site. This explains about cloning done. Okay, this region, it is more than one in a plasmid, or it may be only one in a plasmid structure. If this is more than one, in this case we will say it is a polylinker. If only one site is present, cloning site is present, then it is called monolinker. This is very important one to identify the plasmid at which different types of restriction enzymes we are going to use. The restriction enzymes at the site of cloning region, our desirable restriction enzyme can be used if a plasmid has more than one cloning site. So from different bacterium we can isolate a restriction enzyme. That regions are identified in a plasmid. So the specific introduction, specific restriction enzyme can be used into a plasmid. So understanding this cloning site is very essential. It is very important property exhibited in the plasmid structure. So in our next class, we will see about other important types of plasmid.